This conference will now be recorded.
Let me open parent and child cases. Other points which I have to tell you today is still the relation between parent and child. Let me go ahead and create a parent case. Child cases are created. This is very, very important to understand. The one which I'm going to tell you now, relation between parent and child. Okay. All this is a technical implementation or predefined design provided. Similarly, we can also design by ourselves. But it is a provision available, that is what the technique of case management. Parent and child cases are created, right? You go to PY work page of any of the cases, whether it is parent or child, no matter. But if you go to PY work page of parent or child cases, you will see two properties which we need to bother about. Let me copy those two properties onto Notepad. What is the name of the two properties? PX covered count and PX covered count open. Let me explain you this. Okay, PX covered count open. See, PX covered count means how many number of child cases created at that moment of time. If you go to PY work page, at the moment of time, how many child cases are created by the time will be the integer value will be assigned to PX covered count property. Let me tell you one example. My case design is like this: parent case, child case type 1, child case type 2, child case type 3, child case type 4, 5. 5 child case types are there in the design, and parent case type is there. When you run the parent case type, instantiation is 3 child cases have been created. Okay, 2 are yet to be created. Now what is PX covered count value is 3. PX covered count is equal to 3. Someone is working on the cases. At some point of time, one more child case is created. What is PX covered count? 4. After some time, one more child case is created. What is PX covered count? 5. This is clear? Basically. Now let me tell you the same design. First 3 child cases created. What is the PX covered count value? 3. After some time, one child case has been resolved and another child case has been created. Now PX covered count value is 4. PX covered count is equal to 4. After some time, 2 child cases have been resolved out of remaining 3 and one more is created. PX covered count is equal to 5. So PX covered count means total number of children created, that's it. How many resolved are not, no matter. Okay, total number of child cases created by that time is PX covered count value. Everyone clear with this? Now let's talk about PX covered count open. You should be able to tell me this. The cases which are yet to be resolved, how many are available now apart from the resolved cases? Let me tell you, 2 work objects created out of 5 initially. Covered count is equal to 2. Covered count open is equal to? I have 5 child case types, parent case executed. 2 child case types have instantiated work objects. 3 are yet to be created. Covered count is equal to 2. Covered count open is equal to 2 only. 2 cases are open available. After processing, one case has been created. One more case, one is resolved. One resolved, one created. Covered count is equal to? Covered count, first property. Covered count is equal to 3. Covered count open is equal to? PX covered, okay. Initially, PX covered count is equal to 2. 2 are created, 3 are yet to be spanned. While processing, 1 is resolved, 1 is created. Total, how many created by this time? 3 created so far. Covered count is equal to 3. Covered count open means how many are yet to be resolved in this? 2 are yet to be resolved. 1 is completed. Covered count open is equal to 2. Now how many open? 2 open. After some time, these 2 resolved, 1 is created. Covered count is equal to? Covered count is equal to 4. Covered count open is equal to? 1 is open. After some time, one more case created. Covered count 5, open is equal to 2. Everything is resolved. All child cases are resolved. Covered count open is equal to? 0. Covered count open is equal to 0 means there are no child cases to perform. At runtime, for a given parent case, you have to write the logic. to see whether all children are being resolved or not. What is the logic you have tried? Covered count open is equal to 0. If covered count open is equal to 0, that means this parent has all child cases resolved. Okay, for that OOTB, when condition is available. Okay, all covered resolved. Using this when condition, you have to explain me one of the requirement which I am going to ask you. I'm sorry, not this activity. I'm talking about when rule. Chapandi. Now the requirement is, this is parent case. After this parent case, suppose if I click on submit in the transaction details, it should verify all the child cases are resolved or not. If resolved, okay, it will go forward. Else, it should stay back on the same screen displaying a message, still there are pending child cases, you cannot proceed forward. That is the requirement, how to implement this requirement. On submit, okay, submit, it should check all resolved or not. If not, it should be there on same screen, else it should go forward. How to design this? You should have clear knowledge about this. Chapandi. You will add decision shape, okay? Decision shape, one direction will connect to forward, one direction will connect back to same shape. Come back and connect to previous shape. What is the condition there? All covered resolved. True means it will proceed forward, else it will come back and be on the same. Instead of using decision shape, tell me other approach. Any other approach? Where approach happened? Instead of using decision shape, you have to use the same condition, tell me other approach. So can I write a validation rule? All covered resolved, so PX covered count open is equal to 0, message I will give. On submit, I will be calling validation. That validation will execute and check all covered resolved true or not. Accordingly, it will be there on the same screen. If it is not satisfying, else it will proceed forward. This is also another approach. Everyone clear with this? If you don't understand this, means you did not work on previous OBJ validate or something. You can do it by using decision shape, or you can do by using, which one is better in these two? Validation. OBJ decision shape, if you use, what happens, you know, after you submit, assignment will be completed. It will proceed forward, come back and create the same assignment. That is not correct. Okay, so you always better use, suppose it is validation, it will not complete the assignment. Verify that it is successful or not, it will be there on the same assignment without doing anything. Okay. Other than this, we have another approach. I will show you that for your information. I will send you the notes. No worries. By looking at the shape itself, you can tell me the purpose of the flow shape. Now I am going to show you one of the flow shape. Tell me the purpose of the flow shape. What it will do? It will keep the work object not being performed by anyone. Means waiting. Waiting by what factors? Looking at the flow shape, you can tell me one of the factor. After choose chapandi. Flow shape, you look at and tell me. Based on what factor? One of the factor is time basis. Clock symbol. If you go over here, you can just mention the time. Timer. You can hard code it, or you can refer by a property. Number of days, 3 days I have given. 3 days, no one should be able to perform that particular work object. Okay, during this moment, where this object will reside? Work table. Okay, so this is an alternate shape of assignment actually. So this will be there in a work basket. What is the name of the work basket? Default at the rate till the, when it is reaching wait shape, means it will be there in a work basket. That work basket, you don't give access to anyone. After 3 days, automatically that it will release, it will be released out of that basket called default at the rate vega.com and move forward. This is clear. Other than time, we have other approach, that is, what is the case dependency? I'll only tell you one of the option here which you can better understand. Case dependency, all cases of type approval are like all cases of verification to be resolved. Any verification, sorry, insurance case, every other case in the insurance should be resolved, it will proceed forward. This is another approach. This is also will complete the previous flow shape and make it wait. If that is the case, you proceed with this. Suppose you should not even complete that particular shape, then it should be validation, something like that. Okay, everyone clear with this? All covered resolved, you can make use of all covered resolved in what scenario? Whenever you wanted to verify a condition to see all the child cases have been resolved or not. If resolved, proceed forward, else we have the same student somewhere. Suppose if not resolved, you have to go back to previous. Okay, let me tell you one example. Now case is at this place. The design requirement is all covered resolved, it should go here, else it should go to first stage. Let's say how to design that. You understand the requirement? When everything is resolved, it will proceed forward, else it should go back to first stage. Now, okay, you are using decision shape, okay. Decision shape use, it will go forward. All covered resolved. If not, you have to come back to stage one. How to come back to stage one? Chapandi. How a case can move from one stage to another stage? By using what?
Change stage.
Change stage. So after the decision, you have to add automation shape. What is that? Change stage. Change to a stage. Double click on that change to a stage. And here, which stage? I wanted to go to first stage, some other stage, basic info. So when it encounters this flow shape, it will change from current place to basic info stage. It will go back. This is clear, everyone? So this is how you can jump between the stages. This is a knowledge for your information. Everyone cleared about PX covered count, PX covered count open. Now, PX covered count minus PX covered count open is equal to number of cases to be resolved. Suppose business is asking, at certain point of time, you have to display how many are yet to be resolved. How many are resolved? How many are resolved? Then you are going to find the difference of these two and then display in the UI. Okay, this is clear. Next, we'll talk about more about PY work page of this one. Go to clipboard, PY work page. So under the PY work page of parent case, where is it available? Maybe I'm looking at different thread or same. Under the PY work page, you know these two properties now. Under the PY work page, you have something called PX covered INS keys. By looking at these key values, you have to tell me what are these? PZINS keys. These are PZINS keys of what cases? Just give me 1 minute, please. These two are there under PX covered INS keys. PX covered INS keys has PX covered INS keys of 1, PX covered INS keys of 2. Okay, now this is clear, everyone. Now tell me, PX covered INS keys is going to hold PZINS keys of what cases? This is where the relation is defined. For a given parent, what are the child cases? How process commander knows at runtime is by PX covered INS keys is going to hold all the PZINS keys of child cases created so far. Now, let me ask you one question. What is the property type here? You know property type, single value property, page list property. Page group also, you know. What is this one?
Page list.
What is page list? Page list means page should be there, under page there should be value. But do you have value assigned for directly this one or under this there is a property? Value is there directly for the index parameter. It's not there again under index page, it doesn't have any property. This is a different mode. This is called value list. You know arrays in C language? One property holding multiple values. Is it possible? A property can hold multiple value. How it is possible? By arrays. Variable can hold multiple values when you use arrays in C language. Same arrays in Pega you call it as value list. Value list is also one single property holding multiple values by its property name with indexes. This is an example of, but generally you will not encounter with any value list properties while you are real time programming and all. This is OTP. Okay. For each embedded page, you know, similarly we have one of the option there for each value in value list. If you give value list, for each value in value list, it will loop through value list. Okay. Now, so the PZINS keys of all child cases will be made available to parent case on an OTP value list property. This will be asked in interviews. What is the property name? PX property name, not property mode. Property mode is value list, property name is PX covered INS case. Remember that forever. Format is PX covered INS case of 1, PX covered INS case of 2, 3, 4, each one will have a value. Now, my requirement is you are writing an activity at parent case. Imagine in the case designer, you have a utility where you are writing activity using which you wanted to fetch the work of the details of child case. By using OBJ, opener, OBJ open map, handle it's up to you. Okay, my requirement is you have to write an activity in the case design of parent case. Here there is a utility. This utility should fetch the work of the data of child cases. Okay, for that you are writing an activity using OBJ open map handle. OBJ open map handle, if you are using, you need a key, right? What key you need? Instance handle. Page INS key. Where are you going to read the page INS key from? PX covered INS. That is how you can make use of it. When you know this, then only you can do implement your requirement. If you don't know anything about PX covered INS keys, then you cannot do anything. Because at a parent case, how would you take the child case PGINS key dynamically? No one is passing that. You have to loop through the value list and you have to read the value and then use it for opening the record from the database. This is clear, everyone. This is how your PGINS keys of child cases will be made available to parent case under PX covered INS keys that defines the relation between parent and child. Plus, parent, if it wants to access the work of the data of any child, has to read the keys from here and do OBJ open map handle. Everyone clear? So these are the basic technical concepts of what is that? Case management with covers. Other than this, I will tell you few other important parameters are there. Everyone clear with this? Okay. Next thing is locking. Okay. Next thing is locking. If you go to parent work object, locking can be defined here. Default locking. You know default locking already. Suppose there is a work object available. Work object is opened by operator 1. Operator 2 also tries to open the same work object. Will he be able to open or not? Because lock is acquired. What is the background functionality of locking? How process command identifies lock is acquired or not? It is going to insert a record. Where? In which table?
Yes, it's locks.
PR syslog. At what moment it inserts the record? That is most important. At what moment record will be inserted? Whenever some operator is trying to open, it will check the table. No record, it will insert the record. Okay. No one else should be able to open. This is clear. This is the concept of default locking. Default lock time, idle timeout is 30 minutes. If you want to override, here you give 20. So what is the default lock timeout now? Idle timeout? 20. It will read from here. Okay. Default locking you are aware of. There is other type of locking available in Pega. Okay, it is for normal processing or covers concept, both are same. This is optimistic locking. Optimistic locking means lock will be acquired only when an action is taken, not at the moment of open. Means you try to open, it will not check the lock table, it will open. If you apply optimistic locking, a work object can be opened by n number of different operators at the same time. Everyone will work on that. At what moment lock will be acquired is only when an action is performed, lock will be acquired. After the action is committed, lock will be released. Means at what time lock will be acquired, can you tell me? On submit. When you perform an action, that can be any action, out of which one of the action well known is submit. When a submit is done, lock will be acquired. After submit is completed, lock will be released. Everyone clear with optimistic locking? Will acquire a lock only when an action is being performed. That can be any type of action. Out of the actions, we know submit action. Now let me ask you a question. You have to imagine and tell me. This is how interviews questions will be asked. We have one flow, start shape, two assignment shapes, and end shape. Okay, first assignment, let's say you are using split for each, for example. First assignment is routed to three people. This is following optimistic locking. Two operators it has been routed. Assignment is routed to two operators using split for each. Operator 1, operator 2. Okay. Okay, it cannot be split for each, it can be normal assignment only. That is there in work basket. There is an assignment, assignment 1, assignment 2. Assignment 2 routed to some basket. Basket 2, assignment 1 routed to basket 1. Okay, this is following optimistic logging. Flow is executed. Once it reaches first assignment, it is there in basket 1. Basket 1 is accessible to operator 1, operator 2. Operator 1 can see the task, operator 2 can see the task. Operator 1 has opened the assignment. It is following optimistic logging. When you open, will there be any log acquired? No. Now operator 2 has opened. Will he be able to open or not? He will be able to. Now two resources have opened the assignment from the basket, filling up a form. Okay. So they are trying to fill the form. At the same time, both have submitted. Let's say operator 1 has submitted. Operator 1 has submitted at 9:15. The submit action is taking 1 minute. For example, to complete the submit action, it will take 1 minute. At 9:15:30, operator 2 has submitted. What will happen? Operator 2 will get a message saying that work update is locked. This is clear, everyone? They both submitted at the same time. Now what will happen? Deadlock. It may not happen. But when the action is performed, lock is acquired during the action being processed. If someone else tried to perform any action, locking issue will happen, not at the moment of open. That is what default locking. Amy, open. This is clear, everyone? So far, everyone clear? Default lock. Now my question is, operator 1 has submitted at 9 o'clock. Submit action is completed. 9:15 is submitted. 9:16 completed. After 9:16, operator 2 is still filling the form. He has completed after 9:16 and he is submitted. Now, operator 1 is submit, this data will store into work table or not? It will store into work table. That is completed. Action is completed. Lock is released. At 9:16, the form is open and someone else is filling the same form, right? Parallelly, he also submitted at 9:16. Now, he has given a different data. Now, if you go to backend and see what data will be available, what happens to operator 2? Will he be able to submit or he will not be able to submit? This is first option. Second option, he will be able to submit and data will be there, updated data will be there in the database. Out of these two, which one you will choose?
If at same time, then we can't submit at same time.
Question in Narana, in Japan already, same time.
It's second one.
Not same time. He should be able to submit or not? First, that is my question. He should not be able to submit. What is the reason? Tell me the reason. I told you answer. Status.
Because it is the AS has the same PGINS key.
So, no, not about PGINS. See, when first operator completed, assignment is completed or not? Assignment is moved out of the work basket. Now, second operator has image of the same. When he submit, what will happen? PRPC will say, this assignment has already been completed. You cannot do any action. And it will display OTP on the refresh button. Click on refresh button. It will be disappeared from this one. Okay. This is how you have to answer. You should think about assignment is there or not there. They are parallelly working on it. One person completed means assignment would have been completed. Then second person should not be able to do it because there is no assignment to perform. You have opened it sometime back. By the time you submit, someone else has already completed this assignment. There is no assignment. It will move to next assignment. Okay. This is about optimistic logging. Everyone clear with this? Next. Let's leave about optimistic logging. Now let's go ahead with completely you leave about optimistic logging now. We are going to discuss everything with respect to default logging only. I've opened parent cases. Now parent case settings tab, you have logging. These will be asked in interviews, you should know. Default or optimistic, you choose, I have chosen default logging only. Okay. Now verification case, settings tab, logging. There is no option provided. Instead, what is written here? Logging strategy is inherited from parent case. What does that mean? Type of locking, what is chosen at the parent is applicable to child. There is no way you can add a different locking or locking for the child at all. Is it same for all children or not? This is same for all children. Means parent case, whatever the locking that is being followed, child also will follow the same. That's it. Everyone clear with this? Now we will discuss about this option. Do not lock the parent case when the child is open. Let me tell you the default behavior of covers. Imagine we have a parent case, two children. Parent case, once you execute, parent is created, children are created, their assignments are appropriately routed to different operators. Everyone clear so far? Now, case management covers concept purpose is parallel process. Child 1 is opened by operator 1, child 2 is opened by operator 2. Parent object is opened by parent operator, some other operator. They will be able to parallelly process, right? That is what case management with the covers and that is needed. But they should not be able to process, because the design of case management is not like that, to be able to process parallelly. Let me tell you how the design is. Anyone opens the child work orbit. Suppose if you open parent work orbit, lock will be acquired on parent case or not? Someone opens child work orbit, lock will be acquired on child work orbit or not? Default locking only. Everyone clear? Now, the design of PEGA is like this. If anyone opens the child work orbit, anyone of the child work orbit, lock will be acquired on child work orbit plus lock will also be acquired on parent work orbit. This is clear, everyone? So if someone is going to open one of the child cases, lock will be acquired on the specific child plus lock will be acquired on the parent. This is how process commander will try to acquire and acquire. Okay, keep this in mind. Let me ask you a few questions. Now, parent case, two child cases created, appropriately routed to different operators. Operator 1 has opened child 1. Lock acquired on child 1 as well as parent 1. Some other operator trying to open parent case. Will he be able to open or not? Will he be able to open or not able to open? He will not be able to open, because whenever parent case is being tried to open, it will try to acquire lock on parent or not. Already parent is being acquired lock by child operator as part of child case open. So it is disturbing parallel processing. Another point. Operator 1 has opened child work orbit 1, which has acquired lock on child plus parent. Operator 2 is trying to open child 2. Will he be able to open or not? He will also be not able to open. Reason being, when he try to open child 2, it will acquire lock on child 2. It will also try to acquire lock on parent as part of the default design, which will fail. So where is parallel processing now? There is no parallel processing with case covers also, right? So this restriction is added for some business reasons later. If you want to achieve parallel processing, you have to select this option. You can tell me, do not lock parent when the child is open. Now selecting this option on all children. This option will be available only to child cases. It will not be available to parent case. On all children, in the settings tab, child case tab, I have selected do not lock parent. Now parent case is opened. Lock will be acquired on parent. Child case is opened. Lock will be acquired on parent. Child case. What about parent case? Lock will not be acquired. Someone try to open parent. Will he be able to work on or not? Someone else try to open other child. Will he be able to work on other child? Also has this option. So if you want to achieve case management parallel processing, this option must be selected. Otherwise, it won't work. Okay. Can I have this option selected for some child cases, for some child cases not selected? Possible. Suppose you have dependency. When child 4 is being worked on, no one should be able to touch parent or other children. This is the business requirement. That can be any business. Now, what you have to do? This option should not be selected on child 4. Everyone clear? That is how we'll be. That is the purpose of this option. Next, another point. Everyone clear with this? So we have understood about all covered result, all covered count, open, and covered INS keys, and then locking default and optimistic, and locking strategy between parent and child, and parallel processing to achieve by do not lock parent and the child. All these are concepts. Now let me tell you one requirement. It's not about case management. Generally, you tell me how to implement covers and covered concepts only. Parent case, that is parent case is recruitment. This is parent case. HR manager is going to log in. He will execute a flow called recruitment. Parent case first form will be displayed, new harness. In the new harness, he will select the appropriate options. Technology 1, Java, number of positions open is equal to 5. Okay, technology 2, .NET. So number of positions open is equal to 5. He will choose like this in the forms. dotnet and then pega. Number of positions open is equal to 5. Everyone clear with this? So this is how he has selected the options. Once he click on submit in the new harness, parent case is created with number of positions open is equal to 15. And three child cases have been created, java.net pega, appropriately routed to the respective recruitment teams. Everyone clear with this design? Now my question is, they will open the assignment. When they will open the assignment is, whenever they hire a resource, they will open the assignment and they are going to select the option of hide or not. When they hire, this will be updated to, suppose if they hire one person, it will be updated to four, something like that. So number of positions hired, initially what is the open? Oh, okay. I'll tell you like this. One more property I'll add. Number of positions filled is equal to, initially what is the value? Zero. This property is there. Everyone clear with this? This is the property. Number of positions filled is equal to, here also, this property will have these values. They started recruitment process. Once they recruit a candidate, they are updating the number of positions filled with along with the value. They have recruited two resources, Java. Now, what is the number of positions filled at the parent case? Two. It should be automatically updated or it has to be manually updated? It should be automatically updated. Number of positions filled for .NET is equal to 1. What is the number of positions filled here? Number of positions filled for Pega is equal to 3. What is the number of positions filled? This is the requirement given you to design. All child case types, everything is there. Now calculation requirement is given to you. How to implement this? Declare on change. Declare on change is the ekkada chestaru ala chestaru. Tell me, suppose you have done declare on change. How many declare on changes? One or n? Three number of declare on changes. Suppose it is four? Four. Five? Hundred? Hundred declare on changes. Hundred activities. Whenever this is changed, you need to open parent case and update the parent case and save it back to database. Suppose you declare on change will not work. It's not about the change of the property value. It's about saving into database also matter. Declare on change will not work. Declare expression will not work. Then what is the value?
Declare trigger.
Declare trigger. After this recruitment is done, selected means it should update back to database. When it is database updated, then only it should reflect into parent case. Value change, again you have reverted somehow, let's say. Then on change means it will already update the parent case. That should not happen. Declare trigger is the solution. But writing a trigger, how many triggers you will write? So that is also wrong. Declare trigger is also, writing your own declare trigger is wrong. So Pega has come up, okay, declare trigger solution is correct. But you are not needed to write your own declare trigger. Pega has come up with a solution for the same. Settings tab, calculation, calculations. Add a calculation. This is only for sum. It's not for subtraction and multiplication. Property 1 at parent case is equal to sum of first child case, property 1, second child case, sum property, let's say y, let's say here it is x, here it is z. Z is equal to x plus y. That is what we were discussing about. If you suppose, that means number of positions filled is equal to child case number of positions filled, child case 2 number of positions filled, child case 3 number of positions filled. That is sum of the sum. Okay. So this design internally declared trigger. Okay. So if given this kind of requirement, if you want to implement, you need not to write your own declared triggers and all. You use this feature available in case type rule, it will work fine. This is clear. This is going to eliminate the need of writing your own declare triggers and all. Internally it is trigger only, but you need not to write all these triggers and all. Whenever any child case, this property value is being stored into the database, then immediately property value available parent will be updated and stored into database. This property value changed and stored into database with the latest value, this property is going to get calculated and then stored into database appropriately. This is calculation. If they ask you any this type of requirement anywhere in the interview, solution is you have to use calculation sharp. You should not be saying like declared Egger and all, that is manual process, but automation process available in Pega is this one. Everyone clear with this? So this is about declare, sorry, calculations tab, which is available in. This will be useful more when you have parent and child cases, not for single work object. Single work object, you can create your own trigger, done. Okay, so this is about case management techniques and terms which are available. Remaining things are everything what we have learned. So most importantly, we have PX covered INS keys, PX covered count open, all covered resolved, data propagation, and update a case, calculations tab, and locking strategies. These 9 points all about case management techniques which are available predefined. Okay, like this you can design your own management techniques by yourself if you wanted to design. Okay, all that what we have learned, Pega, is core part. Case management covers concept is a design from what we have learned, that's it. But if you know only by PX covered INS keys, if you don't know, you cannot do anything. Knowing that is most important. How to use is the core design and development, like looping and getting the value and opening the data or somehow, that is what. When you know PY work cover, then you will eliminate the need of opening the parent work object. Instead, you will directly read from PY work cover. You don't know about PY work cover, then you will write the activity obj open and all, which will work, but which is wrong. No need of writing additional coding when it is already available given in Pega. Everyone clear with this? So this is how your PRBC's case management is being defined. Okay, so the videos which you have to watch, let me explain you about rule sets. Okay, see, you can watch a video, application rule set, types of rule sets, application rule set, branch rule sets. You watch the video, you'll get the knowledge. Okay, this is one video. Second video is rule delegation, same order you have to watch. So it is completely given, that's why I'm referring the videos to watch. If they ask you in interviews, this will be helpful. Regularly you will not be working on all this, which I'm going to tell you. Application types of rule sets, application and branch rule sets, and then what is the other one? Rule delegation. Rule delegation, DELEGATION. Rule delegation concept is there, implemented and given in the video. You can watch the YouTube channel video. Completed, done. This is about two videos which you have to watch. Apart from this, skimming concepts are available already. Performance analyzer, PAL, clear video is there. I do not want to explain that, it is already there. Exception handling, I have told you, still you can watch exception handling video. Three videos are there. Exception handling clearly explained. One weekend you can complete all this. I think these are fair enough. Exception handling, same exception handling concept, three videos you'll get. Watch three videos. You will be able to understand few more points in that. Okay, everyone clear with this? Let me go ahead and talk about the next one. Rule sets. See, what is the personal rule set? They may ask you in interviews, but let me explain you. Dynamic system settings I have to teach. Now, let me complete dynamic system settings tomorrow. Today I'll teach about, remind me tomorrow, I'll tell you dynamic system settings practically. Okay, today what is personal rule set. Application rule sets, you know. Production rule sets, and branch rule sets, if you want to know, you go to the YouTube channel. Production rule sets, add one more point, production rule sets. Videos are there. The one which is not available, I'm going to tell you now, which is called personal rule set. I have never told this to anyone so far, I believe. Personal rule set. See, let me ask you one question before I explain. We have a customer details form section created with some fields. It is checked in. Three operator login, same rule will be picked when they execute the flow, three operators will get the same. Okay. Now, operator one, as a developer, you have logged in, you have checked out the rule, and you have made some modifications. That's it. You did not check in back. Checked out, make some modifications, save. Now you executed the flow. Other operators, when they log in, they are executing the same flow. As part of three of your execution, operate customer details section is displayed. UI is displayed. Now you will be getting the modified screen, or you will be getting the check-in copy. Check-in copy will be displayed, or checkout copy will be displayed to you. Which one? You have logged in, you have checked out customer details form, you made some modifications, save it, you did not check in back. You have executed the flow. Now, is it going to display the checkout copy or check-in copy? Which one? Checkout copy only has to be displayed. That's what you are doing testing now. So checkout copy will be displayed to you. Okay. Other operator, when they log in and execute the flow, they will be getting checkout copy of what you are doing or check-in copy. So everyone by default getting check-in copy only. Check-in version of the rule, you will be getting. But if you are the one who has checked out, you will get checkout version displayed. This is clear. Your modifications, your testing. Once you find everything is successfully done and testing is completed, unit testing, then you check in back so that other users will get the access to latest component. Okay. Before itself, if you check in, there are some issues, others also will face the issues. So you should not check in immediately. Anytime you make the modifications, you check out, test it thoroughly, everything is completed, then only you check in back. Otherwise, don't check in. Check in will create issues for other resources. Everyone clear with this concept? Now, checkout version is coming, right? That means checkout is also a version created by Pega. Check-in is one version, checkout is another version. Check-in version is there in rule set version 1, rule set is R1 version 1. When you check out, where it will be maintained? The copy will be maintained by process command somewhere. Let me show you that. If you go to tracer and settings, you know bottom you have rule sets, right? One of the rule sets given here is name of the operator ID, right? Do you have any rule set name with this? Rule set with this name is available. What is this? Is this operator ID or not? Okay, now you go to operator profile. Cancel this. Operator profile will display what are all the rule sets that you have access to. You are part of access group application and all. These are all application rule sets that you are aware of from here to here. Additional to these, there is another rule set available. What is the rule set name? Rule set name is the name of the operator ID. So the concept here is, this is called as personal rule set for yourself, again, which is a virtual rule set. What do you mean by virtual rule set? It will not have physical storage. Suppose in BRPC, operator 1, operator 2, operator 3 login. Same access groups and all, they have all access to same rule sets. For operator 1, when he login, BRPC is going to create a virtual rule set. With what name? Operator ID name. Operator 2, it will create one virtual rule set with same name as operator 2 ID. Operator 3, it will create a virtual rule set with same name as operator 3 ID. Everyone clear with this? This is how process command will create. What will be there in virtual rule set? So virtual rule set contains all the checkout rules by you. All your checkout rules will be there in virtual rule set. That is called personal rule set. Anytime when you are accessing a role, BRPC always picks the role from personal rule set, meaning that it will always pick checkout rules by you. Okay. If no checkout rules, then it will take from application rule sets. Everyone clear with this concept? So whenever you execute, you are getting checkout rule. How come you are getting checkout rule? That checkout instance is maintained in a virtual personal rule set. BRPC always takes from virtual personal rule set instead of application rule set. That is what checkout rules will be there in. Rule should be there inside rule set or not? Without a rule set, rule cannot be available. So when you check out, that copy will be made inside one virtual rule set that is called personal rule set with the name of the operator ID. You log off, virtual rule set is gone. It is only virtual, it will be created. When you log in again, virtual will be created, checked out will be maintained in the virtual rule set. Only checkout rules. Checkout rule should be maintained somewhere, right? In some rule set. For that, TRPC will maintain checkout rule and check-in rule. Both versions are same or different? Same version. So same version, it cannot maintain in one rule set, right? It will maintain in a virtual personal rule set. That is called as personal rule set. Okay, in this video you can get the information about personal rules. Everyone clear with this? So that's it about today. And tomorrow we'll continue discussing about data DSS, dynamic system settings, and I'll practically show you dynamic system settings. Everyone clear with this? Any doubts, any questions about virtual or some rule sets? Clear?
Yeah, quick question. So can you cover on the server side architecture, how the server side looks like?
Application architecture, I'll tell you. After okay. BSS is completed, I'll talk about application architecture. No worries.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to upload this video after some time. Thank you.